Very good morning, all of you friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Kadam Academy. Already we have studied the force vibration, under the force vibration, vibration, mechanical vibration series, we have studied the undamped, damped vibration, and under this force vibration, already we have studied the harmonic force and the what is the frequency response and the phase lag difference curve. Already we have studied that curves also, but now today we are going to study the vibration isolation. This is my Kadam Academy, and the also we are clear the force and motion transmissibility and the force transmissibility. These are the two terms also we are introduced. What is the vibration isolation? Why to study the vibration isolation? We have already studied the various types of vibrations, and the kinds of vibrations are there. They are undesirable and it should be eliminated or rest reduced. For example, the inertia force developed in a reciprocating engine or unbalance produced in the other rotating machinery. Means the in reciprocating engine there is a inertia force, and the rotating machinery there is an unbalanced force will produce. When an unbalanced machine is installed on the foundation, it produces vibration in the foundation and its adjoining structure may face vibration. You can observe in this the mathematical representation of this mass machine, and these damper springs are there. They are connected to the foundation, and this harmonic force or the vibrating force is there. It will be create the unbalance due to the manufacturing defects. There is possibility of unbalanced forces. So this will produce the vibration in the foundation, and its joining structure will be, may get damaged due to the phase of the vibration. So this input force is there. And these are machine bolted on this foundation, and the force is transmitted force, that is Aft, with respect to time, it will be continuously on the machine and the machine to the foundation. This effectiveness of isolation may be measured in terms of force or motion transmitted. So there is the existence of the force and the motion will be there. This force isolation and the motion isolation were to lesser the force or motion transmitted, greater will be the isolation. Isolation will be greater when the force and motion transmitted is lesser to the foundation or structure. That will give the isolation. In order to prevent this transmitted vibration, or minimize the transmission of forces to the foundation by vibration isolation only. So that's why vibration isolation concept is there, which is obtained by placing properly chosen isolation materials between the vibrating body and the supporting structure. So friends, the isolating materials, machines are mounted on the metallic springs or dampers, felt, cork, or on some vibration isolating materials. I will show you. These are the some glimpses or pictures for the vibration isolating materials. Friends, rubber. Here is the rubber. It is shown to you. It is generally used in various industry. It is used for as an isolator when the load is light and frequency of vibration is high. The properties of rubber are affected by heat, oil, gasoline, etc. Hence, it cannot be used in high temperature application. This figure shows the rubber pad is placed between the machine vibrating body and the foundation. Okay, you can observe here also this machine body and this foundation. It is placed in between these two. Okay. Next is the metallic springs. You can see these are the metallic springs. Spring is used as an isolator when load is heavy. When load is heavy, and frequency of vibrations is high. And the springs are not affected by heat and oil. In this case, heat and oil is not there. Is there, but it will not affect on the spring. It will not affect on the spring. And it can be used in all kind of the working conditions. So it is shown in this figure to clear you idea. These are the metallic spring. Okay, this is a felt or cork. Felt is used as an oscillator for heavy loads and low frequency vibrations. It is used only for a compressive type of load. It is used for a compressive type of load or cork. We can see this cork is there. It is not perfectly elastic, but at heavy loads it becomes flexible. It is rarely used as an isolator, but it is suitable only for compressive load. This felt and cork are suitable for the compressive loads. So these are the from BMCS pictures and detail of the isolation materials. The friends will watch.
Some front-loading washing machines have a whole lot of shaking going on. It's especially a problem in the spin cycle. Consumer Reports tested 7 devices that promised to help. Most are pads, ranging in price from $25 to $47.
You place the pads under each corner of the washer. They're supposed to reduce the transfer of vibration to the floor.
To test the devices, Consumer Reports used a washer that vibrates badly. See how this cup of water shakes? Testers added the pads and placed a sensor on the floor to detect any vibrations. A computer analyzed the results. So, did any of the devices help?
Not really. None of the pads reduced vibration noticeably in our tests.
As you can see, the water in the glass is still vibrating. Consumer Reports also tested the SteadyWash isolation platform, which cost a lot more, $200. And at 24 pounds, it weighs a lot more too. The washer still visibly moves from side to side, although the steady wash does reduce vibration to the floor.
You're better off getting a washer that doesn't vibrate a lot, and we found several in our tests.
Friends, these are the details of the vibration isolation and vibration isolation materials. In next lecture, in next video, you can see the in detail force transmissibility and transmissibility curve. What is that curve? What are their conclusions? In detail, I will give you and motion transmissibility. Friends, if you have not subscribed my channel, don't miss it and don't lose the opportunity of various videos. Please subscribe my channel, Kadam Academy. Kadam Academy continues. We go towards the minimize the gap. Thank you very much.